What's up, party people? Greetings and salutations from the Incognito House. Today we are finishing up a series that I've been doing on Walt Disney World cast members. When they go to work at the parks, where do they park? How do they get to their location? Specifically, me as a bus driver, which parks had a bus route and where did it go? Where did the cast members pick up the bus? Where did they drop off? A little bit of a behind the scenes look at some of the cast member transportation around the parks. My name is Ichabod Bones, AKA the Incognito Mouse, but you can call me Icky. So today we're finishing up the series. We're talking specifically about Animal Kingdom, Disney's Animal Kingdom Park. One of my favorites, because it does have a backstage cast member bus route. Interestingly enough, most people who got this route didn't like doing it. They hated doing it. I really liked it. It was a very short route. We'll cover it in a few minutes. It was literally like an 8-minute route, and you would do it from the time you started till your lunch break, and then sometimes you'd go do something afterwards after your break, but a lot of times I got the route my entire day, so 10 hours doing the same 8-minute route over and over and over again. Some people thought it was monotonous and got sick of it. I actually quite love that. I'm going to show you why here in a minute. A lot of behind the scenes stuff, a lot of backstage stuff that you could see. I'm not really taking you backstage. I mean, I'm showing you Google Earth, but showing you things that you could go see yourself. You can go on Google Earth yourself and go see. But I'm going to show you cast members that work at Disney's Animal Kingdom, where they park, and how they take the backstage bus around property. Let's go check it out. So if you have not been watching the other videos in this series, I encourage you to check up here in the link. I'm going to, after I create this video, create a playlist for all the videos. I'll put a link up here or down in the description below. Go check out the other videos. What I'm doing is recording on my phone, and I'm using Google Earth on my laptop to show you what you would see. Again, I am taking you, quote unquote, backstage, but I'm not really taking my camera backstage. I'm just showing you some things on Google Earth that you can go and see right now as well as easy as anyone else. So you can see here that we're approaching Disney's Animal Kingdom. You see the dinosaur ride, you see Cali River Rapids, you see Avatar, and this is the parking lot for Disney's Animal Kingdom. So if you're coming in to Animal Kingdom, we're here on Osceola Parkway. We're headed eastbound on Osceola Parkway. You see the signs here, and right at this point it splits, and this part here goes into the park. Like if you're going to park your car, this is the Animal Kingdom, parking lot. This is where you would go in as you were parking your car. But if you're not, this road here to the left goes on back to Animal Kingdom Lodge. It also goes into the bus entrance to the park. So if you've ever ridden the bus, you may recognize this where you're just going right past that. We're going to continue eastbound here on Osceola Parkway a little bit further down this road, and then we're going to go up over a little overpass here, come back down, and then we get to this light here. And if you go straight, you would go to Animal Kingdom Lodge. Zoom out a little bit, you can see back here is Animal Kingdom Lodge, and left goes off property, goes over to training and some other things, bus driver training. If you turn right here, this is where the buses go in, and also where cast members in general go to park. Side note, I did see a gator in that water one time. So this is where the buses would come in, a large retention pond there. And this is all fenced with barbed wire to keep people out. I don't know why there's barbed wire there, but there is. So if you stick to the right here, this is where the customers go to park and where the buses drop off. There's some backstage access here, delivery trucks and managers and other such stuff go back that way. When we come here to this point, we have a turn here where these two lanes here go to the bus drop off, and this is the cast member parking. You can see here the two different bus loops. So if I was working here, I'd go park over here, then I would come here to this little booth here. It's where the transportation managers are right there. I would check in, get my duty for the day, clock in, and then right along up here along the back end of these two loops is where the buses would be staged and waiting, and I would pick up my bus, or I would catch a cast member bus somewhere else, wherever the case may be. But both transportation cast members and all, as far as I know, all cast members at large, correct me if I'm wrong, we'll get to this lot in a minute, park over here. Just general cast members park over there. This is all the entire parking for all of Animal Kingdom, this is it.
But I don't think this is exclusively cast members. I think anybody can park there if they come in from over here. But this entrance is only. And there's someone usually standing. There's like a little booth. I don't know if I can even see it on here. Right. Well, before that. That's a security booth. But right here, there's usually someone standing right about here. Checking for cast member IDs before they come in. And telling them to turn around if they don't have one. So cast members, bus drivers, and others alike would come here, and they would park. So I think, I could be wrong on this, but I think if cast members work in, maybe over in this part of the park over here, maybe they can just walk over here and go in the front gate. The front gate Animal Kingdom is going to be over here. If you walk past the booth, here's a front gate to Animal Kingdom where you would go in. And so maybe some of the cast members park over there. I'm not sure. I mean, go into their work location. But for the most part, I'm going to take you down this secret backstage walkway to where the cast member buses would be and where most, as far as I know, most cast members get into the park. So they would park their car here. They'd walk over here. Crosswalk. A lot of times there's a state trooper here directing cars and buses coming out because it can be people crossing this crosswalk. Cast members walking over here. There's sometimes a steady flow of cast members and the buses coming out, can't get out. So there's a trooper there, like an actual state trooper who will direct traffic. So then coming away from the front entrance of the park, back around this back entrance here, there's a walkway that goes around here. And then you would go over here. Then right here, there is a little booth that you have to swipe your ID to get through. There's like a turnstile. Like with all, you know, the bars, you have to go all the way through the turnstile. You show your ID, you get through there. And then there are two different roads here. So I'm going to skip this for now and come back to that. Because over here is where we're going to want to go. Remember, if you watch my other videos, I told you every park in Disney Springs has a building called Cast Services Building. Or they have a big, huge break room. Big, huge break room with lots of seats. And they have like, everyone has a subway and like a little mini food court and all kinds of stuff. Locker room. So the Cast Services Building is down this way. It's called Pride Rock. So we're going to kind of cut in the middle here. This is kind of weird here. It's like a floating thing. And it's supposed to be part of a bus. So this would be a bus up here, but we're going to skip that for now. In order to get back to cast services where most cast members would clock in, of course, bus transportation clock, cast members clocked in back here, but most cast members would clock in back there. So just like my other videos, if you're working at Epcot or Magic Kingdom or any Hollywood Studios, you better give yourself plenty of time to clock in because it's going to take you a long time to get from where you park to your clock. So you got to give yourself extra time. So way down here, there's a building called Pride Rock, which is the cast services/lunchroom. So there are two ways you could get there. You could catch this bus that comes by like every 8 minutes. Actually, it's more like every 15 minutes. So if you miss a bus, chances are you're just going to walk because it's not that long of a walk. And by the time you waited for the bus, you could have just walked down to Pride Rock to clock in anyway or start your lunch break. And I mean, unless it was like pouring down rain, I would never wait for this bus. I would just walk because I'm sitting on a bus all day anyway and I'd rather get my steps in anyway. So we're going to walk back this way. We'll get to that parking lot in a minute. But if I was just going on break, I would forego that bus station for now. Just give me a second. We'll come back to that. I'm trying to tilt the angle up on this, but it's not letting me. So anyway, we're just going to have to go from the overhead view. It is about a 5 to 10, there we go. It's like a 5 to 10 minute walk, but you'd be waiting along for a bus anyway. So as you're walking along here, this big structure here is the backside of Pandora. So this is the Navi River Journey flight, you know, whatever it's called. POV. Navi River Journey and Flight of Passage. That's it. That's the backside of that building. And when you're coming in on the bus, you can see that building as clear as day while you're driving in. So the cast members would continue on this way, walking past the Pandora World. As you get over here, this is the break room, the Pride Rock that I told you about, cast services. Over here, interestingly enough, Satuli Canteen is right here. I think it is. And in the backside, right back here, cast members could walk across the street and order some of the little hamburger pod things that they sold there. And this is where cast members would walk across and go into the park to go to their different work locations, wherever they went. But they would come out of the park, come across here, and then they would go right in here into the break room, Pride Rock, where they would clock in, clock out. So this is where I would start my day. I would walk from over there, and the bus would pull in right here. The bus would be facing this way to go back people would come out of here to go back to ride the cast bus, or they could just walk. So, like I said, it was like an 8-minute ride, but it was so much fun. They had nice music playing on the bus, so I'd come out here, and then I would just go back the way that we just came. Come back here. Drive the bus back this way. So basically, there were four stops on this route if you count both sides. One here at Pride Rock, then I would come back here, back this way past the Pandora Show Building, come here, and then I would turn here. That would be to go back out. This is where I said the cast members would come in and slide their ID and walk in here. So I'd come here, turn here, stop right here, pick people up who are going into work. Then we'd come back here. And I'm not sure exactly, I'm not exactly sure what this parking lot was for Imagineers, or it's a big parking lot, whatever. I don't know, actually. I'd come back here, and if you know anything about the front entrance to the park, this is the front entrance to the park. This is the Rainforest Cafe. So this is a Rainforest Cafe, and back here, the buses would pull along the backside of Rainforest Cafe, would loop around here. And there's a bus stop right there. So the Rainforest Cafe people would catch the bus back there. They'd get off here. And then I would just go back around. This stop was hardly ever used, because most people who came in would just rather walk. Because you can see that I'd come back here. And this is not that long of a walk. This is a stop we just stopped at a minute ago. Coming back, there's a stop on that side too. And most people, this was the busiest stop here by far. That and Pride Rock. Because as I'm coming up this way, I'm going to make a right and go back to the Pride Rock building. Cast members are coming from the parking lot here, and they'll be streaming across the street to catch that bus. Remember, I'd pull up here, and there'd be like, 15, 20 cast members, whatever, waiting. As I pull up here, cast members that are coming down this way see the bus there, and they come running, and they're trying to catch a bus. They quickly swipe their ID, come through there to try to catch that bus. And I would try to wait for them, because I'm really not on a tight schedule. Once I get back to Pride Rock, I'm going to be sitting waiting for like 5 or 6 minutes anyway until it's time for me to leave again. So, I've got plenty of time. There's no rush. So I'd sit there and wait 3-4 minutes until I didn't see any more cast members coming. But at the same time, I had people on my bus that needed to get to work or to cast services to go home. So I didn't want to be making them wait. Most people that are here going that way have already gotten off work and they're going back. No, actually they're not. They're coming from here to go to work. So I don't want people to wait. They had to get into work. So I try to wait till there's a break. And then sometimes you just pull forward and you leave people behind. I try not to, but, whatever it is, what it is. So that's pretty much it. Then we'd turn right here and we'd go back here again. Past the Avatar building. We'd take the bus here and then come in here and take a left there. Loop around. And then stop right there where you can see where the little oil slick is from the bus sitting. And then we'd wait. And then I would just do that again and again. The whole loop down there and around and back took about 8 minutes. But they gave us like 15 minutes. So I'd be sitting here for probably 6-7 minutes every single time. And you'd probably do this loop, if you're doing it all day, probably 25 times throughout the day, over and over and over. The good thing was every time I stopped here, I had like 6 minutes. I could just shut the bus down and go inside the cast services and use the bathroom. Or go inside and, grab a drink out of the soda machine, whatever. There was plenty of time. There was no rush back here. And again, the beauty of the cast member shuttles is you didn't have to worry about strollers. You don't have to worry about crying guests. You don't have to worry about big ECV electronic, cast services actually back there. But this is the break room here. That was called Pride Rock, where the lunchroom was. All this half was seating. This half was the cafe, the food. The Subway was over there, and then over here there was like a hot grill with burgers and hot dogs and stuff. Over here was like yogurts and parfaits and stuff, and across here was all registers, and then I don't know what was back there. I thought it was like lockers and stuff, but usually that's what's in cast services. But anyway, I loved doing this route because it was just laid back and easy. No rush, no hurry. You didn't have people saying, I'm missing my fast pass, whatever. And for most of the part, during the middle of the day, it was pretty slow. First thing in the morning when all the cast were coming in, it was busy coming this way because they were clocking in. And at night, it was busy this way going back because they were all going back to their car. But other than that, it was very smooth and very slow going. A lot of fun. I loved it. I can't wait to get back. Look, I never noticed this kind of looks like a guitar here. Like the body of the guitar and the neck here. Kind of. I don't know if that's intentional or if that just happened to be. But anyway, I'm not sure what this parking lot is for, other than maybe people that, executives or something that work over here. And also, I don't know about these parking lots either. Maybe some cast members do park over here. If you work at Animal Kingdom or know someone who does, I don't know what this building... Actually, this building is where the safari cars would come in here. I would always see them parked back over here, and they'd be working on them. So this is like a mechanic building. This is like an auto shop. And they would pull them around here. I don't know what this is. What are those? You know what those are for? Some kind of ride. Wow, looks some kind of space ride. What are those rides for? Is that an old ride? If you know what those are, tell me. That's interesting. I don't know what those are for. But this looks like the... Maybe they're the tram. Okay, so that's what it is. That's the Animal Kingdom tram. That's what it is. This is the... I thought that was the front of the car, but that's the back. These are the trams that pull. So this is a maintenance for the trams. And also the Kilimanjaro Safari Tour vehicles would come in here to be worked on. You see there's one right there. All the people sit there and they pull behind there. So maybe the mechanics and people would... Oh, that's not even parking. That's where they would pull in the buses. It is parking. I don't know what I'm talking about. Maybe this is for the people who work there. Maybe this parking lot is for people who work there. I don't know. Not sure. Leave your thoughts. But as far as I know, most customers park there. Maybe some park here. Anyway, a lot of fun. Can't wait to get back. Here you can see the Animal Kingdom Lodge. And it's a safari where all animals will be for the lodge. Kidani Village and Jumbo House there. Thanks for tuning in. Come back next time. Follow us on our journey to Florida. And remember, Masio na hofu is Swahili for they who have no fear. Hurry back.